focus on the riffle pool sequence primarily because of most of the channels in where we live or work are of the riffle pool variety. So we will apply what we have learned so far in the course and now visualize gradually varied flow as it would exist in a natural channel. So you see again the profile of a run, pool, glide, riffle sequence. Over on the right hand side, and the water again is flowing from right to left, you'll notice in the run, the water is getting deeper in the downstream direction. That, as we have known, is would be called an M1 gradually varied flow curve. Getting into the pool, you notice that the water is getting shallower in the downstream direction, or it actually may be getting deeper in the downstream direction. The bottom slope of the pool does not necessarily have to be going in the downstream direction. It can also be adverse. So you can have three types of gradually varied flow curves there. The M2, if the slope would be normally going down gradient, or H1 if it's a horizontal slope, or A1 if it's an adverse slope. As the water enters the glide, it's an A1 gradually varied flow curve, and in the riffle, it's either an M1 or an M2 gradually varied flow curve. Notice that in the entire sequence, normal depth does not exist. If we talk about the normal depth in a prismatic channel, the water surface parallel to the channel bottom at a slope equal to the bottom slope, like we've done up to this point. The conditions for that to exist would be a long channel with constant geometry and constant roughness. You notice those conditions do not exist in a natural channel.